Hello, my name is Kylie, and welcome to Basic Fractions Fair Shares. Are you sometimes asked to share your crayons or share your favorite candy bar? In this video, we'll look at how to share an object or a set of objects with one or more friends. Ready to explore equal parts? Let's split! One of the first things you learned as a young child was to share. But what does it really mean to share? Sharing means you give a part or a portion of something you have to another person. We share for different reasons and in different ways. Sometimes we share because we want our friends to enjoy what we have too, like a favorite toy. Sometimes we share when there isn't enough to go around, like when your best friend forgets his lunch, you share part of yours. Sometimes we have to share money, like when your mom gives you $10 to share with your sister at the ice cream shop. No matter what we share, the idea is that everyone involved is not disappointed with their portion. When you share your favorite toy with your brother, you might share the amount of time you play with the toy. Maybe you'll play with it for a few minutes, then have him play with it for a few minutes. It's still called sharing if you allow your brother to borrow the toy for an entire day or week. You're sharing what you own with someone else. When you share your sandwich with your best friend, you want to be sure you're not hungry in the end, so you give him a portion just like yours. This is sharing as a part of something that is whole. And when your mom gives you money for the ice cream shop, you don't want your sister complaining your ice cream costs more than hers, so you make sure that you spend the exact same amount. Sometimes you can share something at the same time as someone else, like when you share a book and you sit together taking turns reading it. It is still called sharing when a librarian reads a book to a group of children. Everyone is sharing the book at the same time and no one is missing out. And you can even share ideas so that together the ideas add up to a better solution. Each person's ideas are equally important. When you share, you want to make sure everyone gets the same or as close to the same amount as possible. Whether it be time or money or objects. When everyone is satisfied with their portion, this is called making a fair share. So no one will say, "Hey, that's not fair." Unless it's your baby cousin who doesn't know what it means to share just yet. Let's learn more about what a fair share looks like. If you're going to share these jelly beans with your friend, a good way to do it is to say, "One for you, one for me, one for you, one for me," until they're all gone. How many did you get? How many did I get? Is that the same? Yes, that's sharing. We each got a fair share because we each have the same number of jelly beans. This was an example of sharing a set of separate or individual things. Now, let's look at what happens when we share a whole object. What if we shared a cake like this? Would this be fair shares? No, someone would get a much larger piece. That's not fair, it's not the same. When we take a whole cake and cut it into two even pieces like this, then we can share this cake equally. Now, these are fair shares. When we divide a whole object into two parts, you get half and I get half. We call each piece one half, or we can say we cut this cake into halves. That's good sharing. Okay, so what if we shared a cake like this? Would this be fair shares? No, someone would get a much larger piece than everyone else. That's not fair. It's not the same. When we take a whole cake and cut it into four even pieces like this, then we can share this fairly. These are fair shares. So, when we divide a whole object into four parts, you get 1/4. I get 1/4, your friend Billy gets 1/4, and my friend Allie gets 1/4. We call each piece 1/4, or we can say this cake is cut into fourths or quarters, which is a fancy way to say fourths. Wonderful sharing. Okay, so What if we cut the cake like this? Would it be fair shares? No. Some people would get much larger pieces than everyone else. That's not fair. It's not the same. When we take a whole cake and cut it into 10 even pieces like this, then we can share this fairly. If we divide a whole object into 10 parts, you get 1/10, I get 1/10, and 8 other people get 1/10, we call each piece 1/10, or we can say this cake is cut into tenths. You now know how to share fairly, but you are just getting started with fractions. Be sure to watch our other fraction videos to learn more. In the meantime, practice what you just learned on our fun online games and quizzes. And remember to always fair share and always be clever. Hey, hey.